us here at Franklin Field this afternoon for this big game between the Western Conference winners, the Green Bay Packers, and the Eastern winners, the Philadelphia Eagles. A sellout crowd, over 67,000. Franklin Field here, the permanent grandstand holds about 61,000. They've added approximately 7,000 seats around the track, and every seat will be taken for today's game. This will be the largest crowd ever to see a pro championship game. We have an early starting time today because we do not have lights here in case the game should go long. Of course, in the championship game, we will play a sudden death period or periods if necessary. We were down on the field a few moments ago, and we can report at this time that it is like concrete. It is frozen solid. The tarpaulin was taken off this morning, and the sunshine here in Philadelphia has thawed the surface somewhat. It is slippery going. The Packers and Eagles were out for their pregame warm-ups. They were testing gym shoes and the regular football shoes, but they were sliding around, and it's going to be kind of slow going. Now, as the game goes on, the field may become a little bit a better footing because the sunlight probably will get down in there a little bit and thaw the surface even more. Both clubs were ready for cold weather this afternoon. However, the temperature is only about 40 degrees. But throughout this week here in Philadelphia, the Eagles worked out in extremely cold weather. And, of course, up at Green Bay, the Packers had to work out in zero weather. The game today is billed as a test of Eagle air power with Norm Van Brocklin, the National Football League veteran throwing, and Packer ground strength featuring the hard running of Jimmy Taylor and Paul Hornung. This will be true to a certain extent, no doubt, but believe me, the Eagles have a ground game, too, with fellows like Billy Barnes and Teddy Dean, other good runners in there, too. Clarence Peaks, who was injured early in the year, might be ready to go today. And the Packers will present an overhead threat with Bart Starr throwing to Max McGee, Gary Knappe, and Boyd Dowler. But the defensive units of both clubs will have to be alert today, and how well they do their work probably will decide the outcome of the game. At the other microphone, the voice of the Philadelphia Eagles, Jack Whitaker.
Hornung moves up to the ball. The kick, an end-over-end down the middle, and the game is underway. Brown takes it on the four-yard line, across the 10, cutting to the outside, to the 20, and finally knocked out of bounds at the 22-yard line. Van Brocklin at quarter, comes back, fakes a handoff to his fullback. A swing pass intended for Barnes, but intercepted. Just a moment, intercepted, yes, by Bill Quinlan, breaking in from his right-end position on the first play of the game. Green Bay, first and 10 on the 19-yard line. The pass thrown a little high, intended for Barnes, a swing pass in the left flat, intercepted by Bill Quinlan, and the Packers are in business. The handoff goes to Taylor. He's across the 15-yard line before he's hit down there by Chuck Bednarik, number 60. And Chuck Weber, number 51, the middle linebacker. A pickup on the play of about 5 yards. It'll be second and five. The ball just across the 10 at the 9. McGee out about 5 yards to the left. It's a beeper right through the middle. I don't think he got anywhere. Let's see. There's a big pile up at about the 5-yard line, and the Eagles have held. The Eagles have held. Chuck Weber plunged up in the middle linebacking spot there as Jim Taylor tried for the first down. The Eagles ball, first and 10 on their own 5. And this is an indication of what it's going to be like today. We're in for a great ball game. McDonald flanks wide to the right and Retzlaff to the left. Van Brocklin on a delay handoff to Dean, who crosses the 15. Fumbles the ball. And let's see who's got it. Dean was up plenty for a first down across the 20-yard line. But it's recovered by Green Bay. Bill Forrester, number 71, falls on it. And it'll be Green Bay's ball at the 22. And once again, Green Bay has taken over deep in Philadelphia territory. First and 10 at the Eagle 22. The handoff to Hornung, who's coming around the left side, hit by Brookshire at about the 17-yard line. A pickup on the play of about 5 yards. Second and 5 at the 17. An interception and a fumble, both recovered by Green Bay in the opening moments of the first period. No score yet. A handoff to Taylor across the 15 and down to about the 12-yard line, hit by Chuck Weber and Maxie Bond. And now they're getting close to a first down. And I believe they'll bring the chains in to measure. Star. Hand off to Horning, going around the right side. He's hit by Bednarik across the 10-yard line. Bednarik pulls him down at about the 8-yard line. Fred Thurston leading the way with a nice block. A pickup on the play of about 3 yards. The ball at the 20. Star will hold. It's down. The kick is up. It is good. The kick is good. And there's timeout on the field with the score. Green Bay 3, Philadelphia nothing. That's left. Swift left and McDonald right. Barnes and Dean in the backfield. Van Brocklin back, throwing down the middle, intended for Walston. And they're going to call pass interference on Emron Canal, number 45, who bumped into Bobby. Pass interference at the 35, a Philadelphia first down. A quick look into Walston across the 40-yard line at about the 43. But not quite enough for a first down. Let's see where they place it. At the 44, they may have a measurement. Hit there by Ray Nitschke. There's a snap. And the boot. A high spiral. Going down to Willie West. Now he takes it over to Carpenter at about the 16-yard line. And he's hit immediately. Whopped down there by Jerry Reichow. And John Wittenborn, who covered the punt beautifully. And the ball will be placed at the 17-yard line of the Packers. Star dropping back to throw. Going for a long one, and he's got a man open. Jerry Knappel up at the 35-yard line, across the 35 to about the 37, hit by Jimmy Carr and Don Burrows. A beautiful pattern there, and Knappel was wide open. The ball at the 37. First down and 10 at the Green Bay 37. Boyd Dowler flanked out to the right. McGee to the left. Fitchak here to Taylor coming around across the 40, but he's stripped up there by Maxie Bond on an ankle tackle, and Taylor gets to about the 42. Doesn't go very far. Coming over to the left side. It takes a bounce, though, for the Packers and goes out of bounds inside the 20-yard line at the 17. And Philadelphia will take over. First and 10 on their own 17. Right in front of our NBC microphones. And the Eagles once more go on the offensive. Green Bay leading 3-0. About 4 minutes and 10 seconds left in this first period. Handoff is to Billy Barnes, who's cutting back in, gets up to about the 20-yard line, where he's hit by Henry Jordan and Willie Davis. And we'll wait for the officials to mark it. Just over the 20-yard line. A pickup of 3. Second and 7, the ball at the Philadelphia 20. Getting rushed. Van Brocklin's running the ball. A beautiful rush put on by Henry Jordan there, and he made Van Brocklin do something he hasn't done all year. He ran with the ball, and he gets it up to the 24-yard line, and the partisan Philadelphia crowd are giving Van Brocklin a big hand. That's very possibly the first time in the 3 years the Dutchman's been in Philadelphia, but he's run with the ball. So Green Bay has accomplished something today. The ball at the 24-yard line. Pick up a 4 on the play. Third down and 3 to go. 3-0, Green Bay leading. Beautiful high-spiraling punt going to Willie Wood, who takes it at the 40-yard line and is banged down at his own 38 immediately on a racking tackle there by John Wilcox, a rookie from Oregon, 6'5", 230 pounds. Archie Lucas, who is down on there, is limping off for Philadelphia. So the Packers will put the ball in play. First and 10 at their own 37. Boyd Dowler flanked out to the right and Max McGee to the left. Taylor and Hornig in the backfield. A fake pitch out to Hornig. It goes on a second delayed handoff to Taylor, who gets across the 40-yard line. Hit there by Bob Freeman, number 41, and Don Burrows, the left wing and safety man of Philadelphia. Hornig and Taylor in the backfield. Starr gives it to Hornig, who's trying to get outside. Gets across the 45 to about the 46-yard line. A delayed handoff to Hornig that time, hit by Jess Richardson and Marion Campbell. A right tackle and end on that Philadelphia defensive team. Boyd Dowler going out to the right side, and McGee flanked out to the left. Starr going back to pass this time. Throwing out into the flank here to Gary Knappel, who gets the ball at the Eagle 43-yard line. Hit down by Tom Brookshire immediately. Officials placing the ball up at the 42. Second down and one. Max McGee again comes out to the left and Boyd Dowler to the right.
This is the NBC Radio Network.
The 717 from Elmsport.
Philadelphia Eagles, 28. Starr going to the air again. Intended for Boyd Dowler. And complete. Tackled by Bobby Freeman. The pass complete at the Eagle 15. First down and 10 for the Packers. The opening moments of the second period. Taylor trying to get right through the middle of the line, and he gets yardage down to about the 11-yard line. Hit there by Chuck Weber. Taylor folded right through the middle of the line. From the 24-yard line. A slight angle from the 24-yard line. The snap. The ball is up. It is good. It is good. There is timeout on the field with the score. Green Bay 6, Philadelphia nothing. They kick the field goal from the 24 for that second score. 6-0 they lead. The handoff this time to Barnes. Gets through the hole, across the 35, and finally hit down by Bill Forrester from his right linebacking spot. Helped there by Willie Davis. The ball across the 35 to the 37-yard line, and a first down for Philadelphia. The second first down for Philadelphia in the ballgame. And Brocklin going out to the flat, and again almost intercepted by Willie Davis, but picked up here. Let's see what they rule on this. What happened is that Willie Davis coming in there again, almost intercepted a flat pass. It bounced back into Van Brocklin's arms, and he threw it again, and it's incomplete. Intended for Ted Dean. Early in the ballgame, as a matter of fact, the first play from scrimmage for Philadelphia, it was intercepted by Quinlan. Retzlaff flanked to the left and McDonald to the right. Delay handoff there to Ted Dean. He gets through and gets the other yardage up to about the 45-yard line. Hit there by Henry Jordan and Dan Curry. Ted Dean on a delay handoff, slanting off right tackle, brings the ball up to the 45-yard line of Philadelphia. 11 minutes and 20 seconds left to play in the second period. A handoff to Barnes, swinging out right, but Bill Forrester won't let him turn the corner. Number 71, Bill Forrester, playing it beautifully there, refused to be turned in and held off long enough for Jesse Whitman to come up to spill Barnes for a loss of 2 to 3 yards. So it'll be fourth down and 5, the ball at the 43. And again, Philadelphia faced with a funny situation. Green Bay leading 6-0. Brocklin waits a moment and then boots a high spiral. Fair catch signaled for, but the man, Willie Wood, slips and falls down. The ball taken there by John Wilcox. And let's see what the ruling is. This is a very odd one. We've never seen it. A fair catch signaled for, and as Wood signaled for the fair catch, he slipped as the field is getting slick here. But they're giving it to Green Bay at the point of the fair catch, which is at the 20-yard line.
Bart Starr drops back and fires in the flat to Taylor. Maxie Bond and Tom Brookshire make a high and low tackle, and Don Burroughs slips in to make sure. The Packers fall short, and Max McGee is back to kick. Max gets off a low boot that Ron Kramer downs on the Eagle 43. Eagle fans begin to get restless as Ben Brocklin hits McDonald slanting across the middle. The Eagle speed merchant races to the Packer 39 before he's stopped by Hank Grimminger. Again, Ben Brocklin goes back and looks for McDonald. Tommy's open on the 7 to take Ben Brocklin's pass into the end zone for the first touchdown of the game. Bobby Walston adds the point, and the Eagles go ahead 7-6. Let's take a look at the pattern run by McDonald. Tommy almost loses his footing, but he regains his balance in time to take the pass. Hank Grimminger falls off, and McDonald goes across with the touchdown. The quick striking power of the Eagles changes the complexion of the game. The Packers fail to move after the kickoff, and the Eagles take over on their own 26.
Now McDonald splits to the right. Rhett's left is about 5 yards out to the left at the line of scrimmage. Van Brocklin going to the air, has a lot of time now, throwing a long one intended for Rhett's left. Brocklin going to the air again. A swing pass out to Dean. He's down to the 25. Dukes away from Forrester. Gets away from another man. He's down across the 15. Down to the 10-yard line. Hit down finally by John Simak. Third and 8, a big play for Philadelphia. A rush is on here. Pass intended for Billy Barnes, but incomplete. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down and goal to go from the 8-yard line. And now the Philadelphia field goal team comes in. Bobby Walston to kick and Sonny Jurgensen to hold. It'll be a slight angle from the left. He'll kick it from the 15-yard line with a slight angle. There's the snap. Kick is up. It is good. It is good. And the score now is Philadelphia 10, the Packers 6. We'll pause 10 seconds for station identification.
Philadelphia leading 10-6. A handoff here to Horning. He gets a big hole and bolts right up the middle and is still going across the 35-yard line. Hit finally by Bednarik and Vaughn. A beautiful run by Paul Horning. And nice hole and nice blocking work in the line there by Thurston and Kramer. The ball just across the 35. First and 10 for Green Bay. A minute and 50 seconds left to play in the half. It goes to Taylor. He is stopped at the line of scrimmage, but then slides off magnificently to the right side and gets enough for the first down, I would think. Finally hit by Chuck Bednarik. A first down for Green Bay. The ball at the 48-yard line. Fine second effort there by the great fullback of the Packers, Jim Taylor. 6 feet, 215 pounds from LSU. First and 10. And Max McGee to the left. Firing out, the pass completed to Taylor, and he's going down the sideline. Finally knocked out at the 20-yard line by Tom Brookshire. Beautiful run there, and Taylor, with that magnificent balance of his, almost kept on his feet and could have gone all the way. The ball is being placed at the Philadelphia 20. Ballard to the right, Max McGee to the left. Horning and Taylor in the backfield. Starr going way back to pass now. Down the center, he hits Horning. Horning's got a little room, but he's finally upended by Bobby Freeman, number 41, at the Eagle 13-yard line. A pickup of 7 yards on the play, and I believe timeout is called now by Green Bay. 45 seconds left in this half. And, of course, Green Bay would like the touchdown. And for Bart Starr, that's his 8th completion out of 16 tries in this first half. Which gives the Packers time to get their play off. The kick is up. It is no good. No good. It is wide. Horning's attempt from the 9-yard line is no good. And that is the way the half ends. That's the end of the half. And the score is Philadelphia 10, Green Bay 6.
Have come out of their dressing room on the far side, and the Philadelphia Eagles on the near side. The Eagles bench being across the way from us, the Packers right below us. Gold and white for Green Bay with green numerals and green and silver for the Eagles. And the second half about to get underway. Philadelphia leading 10-6 in this 1960 championship game.
The right end is Maple. He's set on the left side this time, however. Here is Paul Hunter trying the left side and gets to the front of the 40. Still going to the 40, smiling, drives to the 50. Paul Horning running beautifully for just about 20 yards and a first down on the Eagle 49-yard line. Horning going nicely. Jerry Kramer opened the hole for McNine. Chuck Weber was the man who made the tackle. Bart Starr brings the Packers out of the huddle again. Takes the ball, takes the pitch out, gives it to Jimmy Taylor. He gets an opening up the middle, down to the 40, to the 35, hit from behind by Bobby Freeman, and stopped right at the 35-yard line. Jimmy Taylor going 14 yards down at the 35-yard line. The Eagles lead as far as 10-6. 9 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the third quarter. Then the first down for the Packers, first and 10. Again, Starr calls out the signal, takes the ball, gets to Horning, and on the left side, gets an opening. Upstairs is across the line of scrimmage and goes for about 40 yards to the 31-yard line. Paul Horning carrying. Kramer and Thurston leading the way again. Those two big guards in there, stopped by Marion Campbell and Maxie Bond. Starr takes the ball, pitches back to Jimmy Taylor, coming around the right side, gets a nice block drive. Down very close to the 25-yard line before he's re-picked up by Marion Campbell and Johnny Nocera. Johnny Nocera hitting very hard in there. They move the ball in and fight it down. Here's Bart Starr down under the center again. He takes the ball, gets to Paul Honey coming out to the right side, hit by Bernard. 25 is stopped. That's the 25. Leon Kyle. And we'll put the ball down. Close to the 25-yard line. Would have to get inside the 25 and about 24 for a first down. A Packer was injured on the play. The timeout has been called. Paul Horning has left the ball game, but he moved off the field under his own power. Seems to be okay. Fourth and about 2 for Green Bay. Here is a handoff to Jimmy Taylor. He is hit by Bedard at the line of scrimmage, twice for yardage. And we'll know in a moment whether or not he made it. The referee, Ronnie Gibbs, in there, points his foot firmly and says he got this far. We might have to measure. It is very close. Chuck Weber teamed up with Bednarik that time to make the tackle. We will have an official's timeout for a measurement.
The Packers driving down inside the Eagle 25-yard line. Jimmy Taylor and the slow going out there is having a little difficulty getting a start. But he managed to get a little head of steam that time. Got a step in there and drove in very hard. And it is short of a first down. Davis, Tanner, Jordan, and Quinlan. Van Brocklin again with the ball, dropping back to pass. He looks, he throws one up the middle. It is complete to Tommy McDonald at the 50. He's down to the Packer 40, hit there by Jess Whittington, and down to the Packer 40. Nice reception by Tommy McDonald. Cutting in from his flanker spot, wide to the right. Took the pass in stride at the 50-yard line. Was hit low and upset by Whittington, stopped right at the Green Bay 40-yard line. So they gained 43 yards on that play. First down and 10 for the Eagles. The ends are in close. Van Brocklin takes the ball, gives to Billy Barnes, trying the right side. He can't find an opening in there, but he does fight his way ahead down across the 35 to about the 33-yard line. Stopped by Henry Jordan with help from Willie Davis. Ball at the Green Bay 33-yard line. Billy Barnes getting 7 yards. Second down and 3. He was hit as he crossed the line of scrimmage, but he managed to move down to the 33 anyway. Calls out the signals. The ball is snapped. Given this time to Teddy Dean. He tries the right side of his own line. Off tackle, gets down inside the 30 to the Packer 28-yard line. A first down for the Eagles. Wayneski making the tackle. Eagles out of the huddle again. Van Brocklin takes the ball, drops back to pass. He looks, he throws. The pass complete to Walton at the 15. He's at the 10. Hit from behind and down at the 5. Johnny Simon riding him down at the 5-yard line. Bobby Walton taking a pass straight up the middle from Van Brocklin. A 25-yard gain and a first and goal to go on the 5-yard line. Well, the Packers are having trouble stopping those Van Brocklin passes this afternoon. 3.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Philadelphia out of the huddle. Here's Van Brocklin pitching the ball back to Ted Dean, coming wide to the right. He is hit behind the line of scrimmage. Drives across the 5 to about the 4-yard line. These Eagles, who lead the Packers by 4 points, 10-6, driving deep into Packer territory. Teddy Dean carrying the ball, stopped by Bill Quinlan at the 4-yard line. Second and goal to go. Gain of a yard on the play. Again, the green-shirted Eagles break out of the huddle. Tommy McDonald set wide to the right. Van Brocklin down under the center. Red Marek is the big center. The ball is snapped. Fake handoff. Van Brocklin rolling out to the right. Throws a pass. Intercepted in the end zone by Simank. And the Packers will have the ball first down and 10 on their own 20-yard line. Well, that stops the threat. A big interception by Johnny Simak. The pass intended for Tommy McDonald in the end zone. Intercepted by Simak. And the score remains Philadelphia 10, Green Bay 6. Packers take over first down and 10 on their own 20-yard line. Here is Starr, take with the ball, dropping back to pass. Throws one complete to Taylor at the line of scrimmage. He's hit him down immediately by Don Burrows. No gain on the play. Little safety valve pass there from Starr to the fullback, Jimmy Taylor. No gain. Up to the Eagle 45-yard line. Max McGee back in fun formation, standing inside the 10. Took the ball, waited for a moment, and ran right straight upfield. He had to get to the 30 for a first down. He made that easily. He was still at top speed. Carried to the 40, then across the midfield stripe and down to the Eagle 45-yard line. First down and 10 for Green Bay. On the Eagle 45. Ted Dean, one of the deep men for the Eagles, made the tackle. So Starr calls out the signal. Takes the ball, drops back to pass, looking for a receiver. He throws one up the middle. It is complete to Canapo, down at the 35-yard line. He is hit and down immediately at the 34, stopped by Burrows and Freeman.
and a first down for Green Bay at the Eagle 34-yard line. The gun sounds, ending the third quarter. At the end of the third period, here at Franklin Field in Philadelphia, the score is Philadelphia Eagles 10, the Green Bay Packers 6.
Apostrophe S.
My hydrate hot dog. Hydrate, it's best.
Back at Franklin Field in Philadelphia, the fourth quarter underway. Packers have the ball first down and 10. Tom Moore just carried the ball down inside the Philadelphia 25 to the 23-yard line. And a first down for Green Bay. First down and 10 for the Packers, with Tom Moore carrying for 11 yards. So Green Bay, trailing by 4 points as we start the fourth quarter, is down deep in Philadelphia territory. Star down under the center, call signals. Takes the ball, gives to Jimmy Taylor, who finds an opening in the middle, goes across, down inside the 20, stopped at the 18-yard line. Bednarik and Weber, with Marion Campbell also in on the play. He carries to the 18-yard line, a gain of 5. Second down and 5 for the Packers on the Philadelphia 18-yard line. The Pack moves back into its huddle. Just into the fourth quarter now. Packers out of the huddle again, down under the center. Call signals, takes the ball, gives to Tom Moore, coming around the left side, cuts back in. He's down across the 15 and to the 10-yard line before he is stopped. Bednarik and Tom Brookshire closing in to make the tackle right at the 10-yard line. And another first down for Green Bay. Nice block that time by Gary Knafel, another by Jerry Kramer. Calls out the signals again. Takes the ball, gives to Jimmy Taylor, who finds an opening on the left side. Runs into one man, but manages to drive down to about the 6-yard line. That was Don Burrows with some help from Tom Brookshire, who made the stop. And it looks as though an Eagle was hurt on the play. Burrows is getting up slowly. And a timeout is called by the Eagles. The Eagles 7-yard line starts under the center. Calls out the signals, takes the ball, looks for a receiver, throws one complete to McGee in the end zone for a touchdown for Green Bay. The Packers just took the lead. A 7-yard scoring pass from Bart Starr to the left end, Max McGee, sliding in from his left end spot. And the Packers go out in front by a score of 12-10. Paul Hawning, who was injured earlier, now moves back onto the field, and he will try the extra point. So the Packers, who led at 1.6-0, then trail 7-6 and 10-6, regain the lead by a score of 12-10. The Packers out of the huddle. They're lined up. The ball is placed and kicked. The kick is perfect. The extra point by Hawning is good. And the score now, the Green Bay Packers 13, the Philadelphia Eagles 10.
Down at 10 for the Eagles. Here's Van Brocklin giving to Ted Dean, who finds an opening in the middle. Hit by Dave Hanner after moving ahead for about 5 yards to the 26-yard line. Play 26. Following a beautiful return of the kickoff, Packers lead 13-10. Van Brocklin down to the center again. Takes the ball, gives to Dean, or Billy Barnes, rather, who cuts back up the middle. Gets down inside the 25 and drives pretty close to the 20-yard line. Carrying to the 20-yard line. 11 minutes and 15 seconds. Or 45 seconds remaining to be played. Here's Van Brocklin back to pass. He's being rushed and is going to be hit and thrown for a loss. Van Brocklin hit by Ray Nitschke and thrown for a loss of about 8 yards out to the 28-yard line. Rich left, wide to the left. McDonald to the right. Here's Van Brocklin back to pass. Rolls to Sherwin. Completes the line. He's at the 25 to the 20. He's hit and is going to be stopped inside the 15-yard line. Billy Barnes taking a short pass up the middle from Van Brocklin. Found himself wide open and carries down inside the 15 to the 13-yard line. Van Brocklin again calls out the signal. Here is a handoff to Barnes, who tries to center the line. He's hit from behind. Gets down very close to the 10-yard line. And it's a first down. First down for the Eagles. The ball just inside the 10-yard line. It was Joe Quinlan who made the tackle that time. These Eagles have 11 first downs. The Packers have 18. Philadelphia now has first and goal on the 10-yard line, just inside the 10. First down and goal. Van Brocklin calls the signals, gives to Teddy Bean, who drives off left tackle, down very close to the 5-yard line. Ted Bean carrying the ball for the Eagles. Big pileup there. Bill Forrester and Bill Quinlan made the tackle for Green Bay. The ball is on the 5-yard line. Downfield after a nice return of a last kickoff. Here is Ted Bean with the ball going wide to the left. He cuts inside the five. He's over. Ted Bean carries for the touchdown. And the Eagles regain the lead, 16 to 13. By now with Tony Jurgensen holding and Bobby Walston kicking. The lead changing hands here. The Eagles lead now 16 to 13. The extra point attempt coming up. The ball is placed and kicked. It is good. And the score now, Philadelphia 17. The Green Bay Packers 13, and the Eagles again have their 4-point lead. The Eagles advance. Dean gets his toe into the ball. Gets off a high end-over-end kick coming down to Simank at the 5. He's at the 10, the 15. Gets away from one man at the 20. Breaks into the clear of the 25. Is hit and going to be down at the 30-yard line. Starr down under the center. Calls the signal. Pitches out to Tom Moore coming wide to the left. He is caught from behind but gets away. At the 35. It's going to be stopped at the 35, the 36-yard line by Chuck Weber and Bobby Freeman. Dollar wide to the right, McGee wide to the left. Starr down under the center, takes the ball, gives to Jimmy Taylor, who drives over right guard for about 4 yards, up close to the 40-yard line. Stopped there by Don Burrows and Jess Richardson. Very close to a first down. We're going to have another timeout, an official's timeout. Those Eagles now, they jump in there to jam up that middle, hand off to Jimmy Taylor, who fights. He went anywhere at all. Boy, Joe Robb, Jess Richardson, Ed Kyatt, Marion Campbell jammed up the middle, and we might have to have another measurement.
They needed just inches, and we are going to have another measurement. They put the chain down. First down. Bart Starr brings the Packers out of the huddle. Here is Bart, the back to pass. He looks, he throws one up the middle, complete to McGee. He's hitting down. The ball rolls away from him, and he's recovered by Philadelphia. The pass was complete to Max McGee, but he was hit hard and fumbled the ball. It was recovered by Maxie Bond at the Eagle 48-yard line. So Philadelphia has possession, first down and 10. On its own 48-yard line. Van Brock Vaughklin brings the Eagles out of the huddle. He's down under the center. Takes the ball, fakes a pitch out, gives to Dean, who was hit at the line of scrimmage, but manages to get up across the 50-yard line and to the Green Bay 48. Ted Dean powering his way for about 4 yards. Second down and 6 for the Eagles. And Brocklin brings him out of the huddle. Tommy McDonald split 15 yards to the right. Here's a handoff to Billy Barnes, who drives to the 45. Inside the 45 to about the 43-yard line. Barnes getting about 6 yards. Third down and about 1 for the Eagles on the Green Bay 43-yard line. The ends are in close. Here is a handoff to Ted Dean, who was hit at the line of scrimmage, but rolls away from his man and might have picked up the first down. Let's see. Well, we're going to have another measurement. It is very close. He got just about a yard. We'll find out in a moment if he got enough for the first down. It was third and about 1. Again, the chain gang moves in. They pull the chain out. And it is short of the first down, still by about a yard. Zone 45. Back deep for Green Bay are Willie Wood and Luke Carpenter. Van Brocklin gets the kick away. High, wobbly spiral coming down to Wood at the 10-yard line. He tries to get in between a couple of men there, but is hitting down at the 12. The punt by Van Brocklin, taken by Willie Wood, who returns just a couple of yards. So the Packers have the ball first down and 10 on their own 12-yard line. Green Bay out of the huddle. Starr down under the center. Takes the ball. Drops back the pass. Rolls to the left. He looks. He throws a pass at the sidelines to Tom Moore. He gets away from one man but runs into a couple of others. Chuck Weber and Joe Robb hitting him and stopping him as he crosses the 15-yard line. They move the ball in and spot it down at the 17. A gain of about 5 yards. A little swing pass from Starr to Tom Moore. Second down and 5 for Green Bay on its own 17-yard line. Moore and Taylor are back. Here is Bart Starr getting to Tom Moore, trying the right side. He runs into somebody right at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Bednarik hitting him, holding him for no gain. Third down and 5 for Green Bay on its own 17-yard line. About 4 minutes and 10 seconds remaining to be played. This is the big one, the game for the championship, the Green Bay Packers and the Philadelphia Eagles. Here is Bart Starr dropping back to pass. Gets nice protection, looks, throws, incomplete. Intended for Gary Knappel at the 35-yard line. Pass incomplete, straight up the middle. So it'll be fourth down and 5 for Green Bay on its own 17-yard line. The Packers will send Max McGee back into punt formation. Packers went ahead 13-10. Now the Eagles lead 17-13. Here's a high pass from center, but McGee gets the kick away. Wobbly spiral. They're going to let it roll. It bounces down to the 35, the 30. Rolling down still at the 26-yard line. Nice punt by Max McGee. Bednarik down over the ball. Van Brocklin calls out the signals, takes the ball, gives to Dean, going wide to the left. Turns that corner, puts his head down, and drives to the 30-yard line. Ted Dean driving for 4 yards up to the 30-yard line. Second down and 6 for the Eagles. The scoreboard clock shows 3 minutes remaining to be played. That is unofficial time, of course. Calls him out, gives to Dean again, who tries left guard. Is hit at the line of scrimmage, but rolls away from the pilot there and gets a couple of extra yards up very close to the 35-yard line. And that might be enough for a first down. Johnny Simon closed in from the secondary and stopped him. Now they have to get just outside the 35. And the ball is just short of the 35. This is a big play right here. Packers trying to get possession of that ball. A handoff to Billy Barnes, who tries to center the line, is hit right on the line of scrimmage. He's fighting for yardage, and the Packers are fighting, trying to hold him back. Big pile up in there. Bill Forrester, Bill Quinlan, Henry Jordan, all making the stop. And let's see where it was stopped. No, he's short of the first down, so it is fourth down. Willie Wood and Luke Carpenter back deep for Green Bay. Van Brocklin takes the pass from center, gets the kick away. A high, wobbly spiral coming down to Luke Carpenter at the 30-yard line. He's going to be hit and thrown down at the 35. Luke Carpenter hit by Gene Dossage and thrown down at the 35-yard line. Let's pause right here, 10 seconds, for station identification. Field again. About a minute and 5 seconds remaining to be played. The Packers have possession. First down and 10 on their own 35-yard line. Here's Bart Starr back to pass. He looks. He throws one. It's complete to Jimmy Taylor, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 40-yard line. 5-yard gain on the pass from Starr to Taylor. That stops the clock with 55 seconds remaining to be played. Bednarik was the man who forced Taylor out of bounds. Second down and 5 for the Packers. On their own 40-yard line. Eagles lead by 4 points. Packers out of the huddle again. Starr down under the center. Takes the ball. Drops back to pass. He looks. He throws one. Complete to Tom Moore. He's at the 40. He's hit and going to be down at the 45-yard line. Just about enough for a first down. And a timeout has been called by Green Bay to stop the clock. And just about 45 seconds remaining to be played. Maxie Bond and Tom Brookshire made the stop that time. They're short of a first down by about a yard. When play is resumed, it'll be third down and 1 for the Packers. The ball is at the 44-yard line. Dowler wide to the right. McGee split out to the left. Here is Starr giving to Jimmy Taylor, coming around the left side, charging hard, runs into somebody and is driven out of bounds at the 50-yard line. Boy, he put his head down and charged very hard into Tom Brookshire and went out of bounds at the 47-yard line of Philadelphia. 9-yard gain on the play. Here's Bart Starr down under the center again. He takes the ball and drops back to pass. He looks. He throws one. It's complete to Canapple. Down at the Eagle 30-yard line. Tries to get away, but he's hitting down at the 30-yard line. 30 seconds remaining to be played, and again, the Packers call a timeout to stop the clock. They have a first down and 10 on the Eagles 30-yard line. Jimmy Carr made the tackle for the Eagles. On the Eagle 30-yard line, Starr down under the center now. Calls out the signals, takes the ball and drops back the pass. Gets protection, looks, throws a long one intended for Dowler. It is incomplete down in the end zone. Dowler and Don Burrows now square off down on the end zone, and the official jumps in between them. Pass intended for Boyd Dowler is incomplete. Jimmy Carr and Don Burrows both were back there with Dowler. Clock stops automatically. It shows 25 seconds remaining to be played. Second down and 10 for Green Bay. They have the ball on the Eagle 30-yard line. Packers out of the huddle again. Second down, 10. Again, Starr takes the ball and drops back to pass. He looks, he throws. The pass is complete to Canapple at the 22-yard line. He is hidden down immediately by Maxie Bond. And the clock is... Packers now trying, lining up, trying to get another play underway. Clock continues to run. 10 seconds. Packers have time maybe for one more play. Starr takes the ball and drops back to pass. He looks, he throws one. It's complete. Down to the 15, to the 10, and he drives to the 9. Jimmy Carr cuts by Derrick, and the ball game is over. The pass was complete to Jimmy Taylor, who drove down inside the 10-yard line, and now the Eagles jumping up and down, a happy bunch. The world champions defeat the Green Bay Packers 17-13, and the Eagles are carrying Buckshaw off the field. The Eagles are carrying Buckshaw off the field. It's all over here at Franklin Field in Philadelphia. The Eagles defeat the Green Bay Packers by a score of 17-13. Well, we had quite an afternoon here at Franklin Field in Philadelphia. Tremendously exciting football game. And, of course, we have to congratulate Buckshaw and the Philadelphia Eagles for a fine season and a fine game. The winners of the National Football League's playoff game, the new world champions.